A few weeks ago, the Archbishop of York and I called for this period of prayer between Ascension and Pentecost. And it is overwhelming to see the enthusiasm with which people have taken it up. The prayer is for the evangelization of England. It's to reach out with the good news of Jesus Christ to every person in a way that is not manipulative or in any way underhand, but that demonstrates the love and grace of God and loves them regardless of who they are, of how they respond, or anything else, just loves. But what a task. What an extraordinarily difficult thing to do. Most of us feel very overwhelmed, even at thinking about it. And therefore, we have to start with prayer. Prayer is the basis of all our actions as Christians. It's the first thing we do as a Christian, is to call out to God. Jesus tells us we call out, Abba, Father, a very simple prayer for help and assistance and love and for God to be alongside us. And if our work as churches in this land is going to be effective, it has to be based in prayer. Prayer changes us, and in prayer, God makes us his partners in a way that changes the world around us. It's the most exciting thing we can do. Many years ago, there was a mission at the church where I was worshiping, and we were all told that we needed to bring people along or ask people about their own faith, and I found that completely terrifying. But there was one person that I felt that I ought to be praying for, and who I was praying for, and I just couldn't think of any way of asking him to come to any of the mission events. Till one day we met, and halfway through a conversation about nothing in particular, he said, "I understand that there's someone talking about what it is to be a Christian at your church. Any chance that I could come along?" God had got there a long time before I did. In prayer, we need to talk to Jesus about our friends before we talk to our friends about Jesus. That is absolutely essential. Over Christian history, all movements of the Spirit of God in bringing people back to faith or bringing people to faith in Jesus Christ have begun with prayer. And that's why the theme of our prayer is not about us. It starts with Jesus, "Thy kingdom come." In the Acts of the Apostles, we see that they start with Jesus. They start with calling out to him, both for help and that his glory may be seen. And the church grew and developed and deepened and made new disciples. It wasn't a case of just adding to its numbers. It was a case of people who fell in love with Jesus Christ and changed the world in which they lived. We dream of that today. The words, "Thy kingdom come, thy will be done," come from the Lord's Prayer, of course. Those words are words simple enough to be memorized by children and profound enough to keep theologians reflecting and thinking forever. We are called to be those who seek the kingdom of God. And to do that, we start by prayer to Jesus, our King, that his kingdom may come and his will be done in our country, among our friends, among those we love. I pray that you will be deeply blessed as you pray and that you will see God at work around you through your prayers in partnership with his Spirit. So let's join together in the prayer that Jesus taught us, which sums up all prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.